Right. Well, I tried to record my audio, my mic on the video, but I messed up. For some reason, in Geforce Experience, which I used to record, I disabled the mic, except for push to talk, which I wasn't using. And for some reason, I don't know, maybe I got confused or whatever, but anyway. So basically in this episode, what I'm basically doing is I'm planning on heading to that bunker, which is on the map there. I've been there before, you know, I've sort of scouted the area out, but I haven't actually been into the bunker. The reason for that is because of the mech, but I've disabled the mechs. So pretty much I'm going to, you know, I've pretty much got loads of gear. Got the M1, which I might end up leaving behind, because I think I'm not going to need it. So anyway, that's what I'm planning on doing. Pretty much going to the bunker and entering the bunker, you know, my first and ever bunker, and see how it goes. Excuse me. Now what I've done is not only disabled mechs, but I've increased the amount of puppets as well by double, so that's going to sort of offset the disabling the mechs, which is just temporarily until I sort of get into the swing of things and I can sort of dodge them or whatever else. Because at the moment I just don't feel confident enough to deal with both the mechs and the puppets. So anyway, so that's what I'm pretty much planning on doing in this episode.
Gathering some food or whatnot, and then hop over to the bunker, take the ATV. Now, I do get a crash around about 12:40, so what I have to do is splice a few of the videos together. It's the same old fatal error again. I think I do get it sorted in the end. What I do is, after about the third crash, I uninstalled the easy anti-cheat software, and then I reinstalled it, so it seems to have sort of fixed the problem. Because I do play for a few hours after it crashes for the third time. Is an inventory space. That's where I want the Hell Rider. Yeah, it's much better than the dirt bike. Faster. unfortunately I've got about 3 hours of video without any audio, without any microphone audio track on it. I mean, I guess what I could have done is just sort of skip, you know, these videos, but I've got like about 4 hours recorded, so I might as well just sort of use them and just try and put a bit of a backing track on them, you know, for the audio. Gonna actually for I think I'm on I think this would be part 77, and so I don't know what part it'll probably be like part 80 something, 82 something like that. And what I'm planning on doing tonight when I play later is to pop to the naval base. I've pretty much filled up the grey pickup with whatever I think I'm going to need. You know, like fuel and water and food and whatever else. I'll just get. Yeah, pretty much sort of full up. Just have a little bit more. It is annoying when, you know, when you're you think you're being recorded, you're not in the end. It is a pain in the ass. Nothing worse than being caught short. So yeah, that's where I plan on going. I think it's gonna rain. The ATV is quite a good little sort of quad bike, you know, motorbike type thing. I mean, it has got a little bit of decent storage on it. You know, it's a good cross country, it's quite stable. You know, it's pretty cool on corners and all that. And it's got quite a good turn speed as well. I mean, 80 kilometres is not bad. With the dirt bike, I think it was started on 50 last night when I was using it. And then it went up to like 56 after I'd been riding it for a few hours. It does feel a bit weird actually playing this without any mechs in it, but, you know, like I said, I've upped the difficulty a little bit by doubling the amount of puppets.
I put my coat on. I figured I wouldn't make a direct approach because a laughing boy in there. And I'm assuming he's, I can't remember, but I think he was inside the place rather than sort of underground. Excuse me, I'm just. Basically, it crashed. So anyway, I got back in and it started me again at the front. So pretty much just gonna get back in there, go around the same way again, just to make sure there's nothing that's gonna jump out in front of me. But I think most of the puppets are underground anyway in the bunker. So there are, like I said, there's about three or four crashes, these fatal error things, but it does eventually, you know, it does eventually get sorted. And amongst those things, there is a massive memory leak with the game. I mean, it just sort of seems to go up and up and up and up. And once it hits about 14 gigabyte of system RAM and about 23-24 gigabyte of virtual memory, it does crash. Confusing where they are to go. Then what I'm hearing is actually from them being underground. He sounds like he's there in the compound, but I'm pretty sure he's actually under the ground. Very, very confusing. He should be sort of right there, but he's definitely not. He's definitely under the bunker. And really, you shouldn't. Really, you shouldn't be able to hear him. Because he is underground. You know, you may possibly maybe hear something very slightly, but you know, it's probably like, I don't know, 6 feet of bloody earth or something between you and the bunker, plus concrete as well. Just very confusing. He just sounds like he's right there. Trying to see if I could get him set off. I think he does actually go off. I mean, even though the mechs have gone, my anxiety going into the bunker was pretty high. figured last thing I need is to be in the bloody bunker and die for a bloody piss.
Moment of truth.
But at this point, there's gonna be people screaming at the screen, going, "Get the fucking in there! Come on, stop delaying!" Whoa, that's weird. Bit confusing here, to be honest, because it sounds like they're just past that corner. They are, but they're behind the door. So they can hear that, but can't get to it. This is why it was a bit confusing for me, because I was thinking, right, well, why aren't they running to it? That's because they're behind the metal door. They can hear it, but they can't get to it. See, I'm just being really super, super cautious. Confusing as well, I can't tell at this point whether they're below me or above me. They can't be above me because that's the ground. So they must be below me, but because the surround sound speakers, it does sound like they're above me, which is a bit weird. Very confusing.
Whoa.
is quite sort of scary when you're in there, and you can hear them sort of all the way around you. That's why I kept coming in and out, because I couldn't quite work out where they were. It's weird, you know, the surround sound, it's like, what the hell? Because it sounds like they're behind you. I think I sort of didn't realise at this point that I was deeper than I thought. So they are pretty much directly above me at this point. It's just super confusing with the surround sound. He right jumped. Fucking hell. But there's literally only one up there. And the rest are behind the doors. Crashes again there.